Hello, today I'd like to show you early parsing with deduction rules. Early parsing combines top-down with bottom-up approaches, so that means it starts at the start symbol and works itself top-down to the beginning of the input string, and for the non-terminals afterwards, it uses bottom-up steps to work itself back up again. It can handle all kinds of grammar, including epsilon productions and left recursion. The items consist of production rules, where the dot says how much of the right-hand side we have already processed. Then there are two indices. The first one states where this item begins in relation to the input string. And the second index says where the dot is located related to the input string. The axiom initializes every rule with the start symbol on the left-hand side and produces items where the dot is at the beginning of the right-hand side. And both indices are zero because we don't have seen anything. Here in this case, we got two axiom items, where the first one is the result of the epsilon production. Epsilon is the empty string, so on the right-hand side, the dot is both at the beginning and at the end of the right-hand side. But this does not lead to any successful trace in this case. So when you look at this item, which will lead us to the successful trace. The dot is located in front of a non-terminal symbol. And every time this is the case, we can perform a predict step with that non-terminal symbol. So we are always handling the next symbol that comes after the dot. So in this case, we need a production rule with the same non-terminal symbol as left-hand side. In this case, we have only one production rule, and that means we are getting a new item that consists of our new production rule and with a dot at the beginning on the right-hand side, and the indices, in this case, they stay the same as they were before. So now we performed a predict step and we are our dot is located basically here in front of the terminal A. And now we can perform a scan step. That means we look at the next symbol in the input string, and if it's the same as in our rule in the respective location, we can move the dot over the terminal symbol. In this case, now it's at the end of the A and at the end of the right hand side, and the second index that says where the dot is located increases by 1. Now we got a new item, which is basically with our dot located behind the A, and also the dot is located at the end of the right hand side of the production rule. And whenever this is the case, we can perform a complete step with the item that previously predicted this item. So in this case, we can use this item from which we predicted the steps coming afterwards. And now we can perform a complete step with this item with the dot at the end of the right-hand side, and the indices have to match. And now the dot, because when the dot is at the end of the right-hand side, that means we have a completed item. And now we have a complete A, so a complete left-hand side. And thus in the other item, we can move the dot over the A, because now we have found a completed A and can move the dot one step forward and also update the index of the new item. So now we are in the situation where the dot is before the S in this tree. And in this case, we can perform another predict step. Now the dot is before a non-terminal S, and we have two S rules we can use to continue. So we can use either this one, which will lead to a new item which has another level of ASB nodes below this S. So this will not, item number 6 will not lead to a successful trace, but we need to perform another step. And this is with the epsilon production. And now, as you can see, we get a new item where the dot is the symbol on the right-hand side of the rule. And the indices of the item stay the same as the one that predicted the new item. Now we have, I have a, now this item corresponds to the dot located here below the S. And because the right-hand side of this rule is empty, we already have a completed item in this case. So we can, with this one, we can perform another complete step with the item that led to this prediction. So it's this one. Now we have moved the dot over the completed S. And the dot is in front of the B, and that means we can perform another predict step. We have only one production rule with the B, and as you can see, again, we will get a new item with the B, with this production rule and the dot at the beginning of the terminal B. And this corresponds to the dot being here. And now, because this B is at the proper position as the B in the term in the input string, we can now perform another scan step and move the dot over the terminal B and increase the index, the second index by one. Now our dot is located here at the end of the B. Here we have the new item with the dot at the end of the production rule, so we have a completed item and can use it for another complete step on the rule that led to this, on the item that led to this prediction. And here again, the index is now updated. And we get another item where the dot is at the end of the right-hand side of a start symbol rule, and the indices span over the complete input string. So the item starts at 0, which is before the first symbol, and ends after 2, which is behind the B or behind the end of the input string. And whenever this is the case, we have a rule with a start symbol as left-hand side. We have an item with the start symbol on the left-hand side and the dot at the end of the right-hand side and the span over the input string. That means we have a goal item. So, and when I'm not mistaken, well, the parser would not deterministically continue with predictions with our item number 6, where I didn't continue because this would not lead to a successful trace. But the parser would try out all possibilities and continue with that one. But I assume this is enough to show you how early parsing works. And yeah, this is how it's to be done.